The first Noel. I thought that I knew what the word Noel means, but evidently I didn't when I started researching. The first Noel, the angels did say, was to certain poor shepherds in fields where they lay. And then they sing Noel, 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 Noel. Did you know that the original meaning means birthday? So the angels are singing over and over again, birthday. And the song seems to have originated in the 13th to 14th century when Europe was springing to life. There were Bible stories called miracle plays, which seems to be where this song came from. And years later, a man named William Sandys wanted to preserve carols, and this was one that was chosen to be among the list. So this song is all about the actual birth of the baby in the manger, and the refrain from most of the song is just Noel, birthday. So why was it so important for the angels to sing to the shepherds, and why would the word that they sing be birthday in these lyrics? I know we often can all shy away from focusing on the baby in the manger and limit it to a kid's play where Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus stumble around on the stage, kids in angel costumes stumble out on the stage, but I'm thinking allowing our kids to be in those performances, taking them to see these type of miracle plays, and even watching the birth story of Jesus in movies and on TV shows helps them grasp the wonder of Jesus' birth. And it can lead to great discussions about why it was the king was born in a manger, who his parents were, and how Jesus was human and divine, and why do we even talk about Jesus' birth at Christmas? I read this. From the poverty of Jesus' birth emerges the miracle in which man's redemption is mysteriously accomplished. Out of poverty, the one who supplies all our needs has come, so why should we ever worry about today or tomorrow's provision? That's a huge revelation when we stop to sing Noel and consider the day of his birth. Jesus also embraced humility as he appeared in the lowliest of birthplaces, unassuming, only allowing his Father to light up the sky with a beautiful star to announce the birth of his Son. We don't ever have to worry that we are unnoticed or no one sees our worth because our Creator totally does. And we don't have to announce it. We're already established in his Son. It has been written that a manger was actually a water trough carved out of stone. It wasn't a comfortable place to lay a baby, but it was actually true that Jesus was enveloped in his Father's arms from day one. And what about the virgin birth? That's one of those miracles our kids need to know about, that nothing's impossible with God and that he gives life. Nothing we do creates life, only God. And like you've probably heard, Jesus most likely wasn't born in December, but rather in the spring. When we celebrate isn't the issue, but the fact that we do celebrate his birthday is. Most of us make big deals out of birthdays for our kids, our older relatives, and we even enjoy a weekend of celebrations for ourselves to give our thanks for another year lived. We open gifts, we purchase gifts, we enjoy good times. We even mark them on our calendars so that we'll be sure to say happy birthday. I love the way Facebook reminds us of people's birthdays so that we can pop a note to a friend. Everyone loves that. So when we sing Noel, 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 Noel this Christmas season or hear it, it's such a sweet, calming melody that sort of just rings and lingers in the air, and we can think a little deeper about that word, birthday. It's a big deal to take note of his birth, maybe as important as noting his death and resurrection. All three, the Trinity, the birth, the death, the resurrection. It's not just a silly story, but it's an incredible picture of the character of the God who loves us. Did you know that God was silent to his people for 400 years just prior to the birth of Jesus? Something that spectacular was about to take place and God kept quiet. And then that star and that young couple and the journey and the shepherds, all that happened succinctly and in beautiful timing and glory. And the angels sang and people came and they worshiped. But some people argued and fretted and didn't believe because the Messiah didn't do what they expected him to do. I don't want to miss the importance of his birthday this Christmas or question the whys of what's happening in the world. But I want to hear and sing Noel and wonder again at the amazing God that sent his Son to a teenage girl, engaged to an humble man, to give birth to the exalted one high above the earth this Christmas season. Noel.